My name's Fergus, and I'm doing a tutorial on how to make a squid lure, squid trolling lure. This is what it's going to be looking like at the finished product.
What you're going to need is a drill to make a hole in the cap, some duct tape. You can use any type of bottle cap. It can be milk, or it can be a tin one, or a wine glass, or whatever. You need a hook, an old swimming cap that you don't need anymore, scissors, some sort of line cutters, and some fishing line. So you've got to cut it about the size, so when you wrap it around your bottle cap, it will still fit. Since I want to make this one fairly big, I'm going to cut it quite big and quite tall. Just cut it out like that. Yep. So that's my piece of rubber swimming cap. Silver one. Yep, real nice. Now that you've got your piece, you've got to get your bottle cap. And you've got to make sure that it fits round. See, mine just makes it all the way around. So after you've got your piece and measured that it fits your thing, you've got to cut little lines in it, like little skirts, so it's like a skirt thing off a lure. So now that you've cut your little skirt here, real wobbly, you can do it like this, and then sit real flippers around. You're gonna want to get your cap and drill a hole through this, but you might want to do this outside. And if you're a kid, have parent supervision. So now that you've done that, you might want to tape it to the cap that you're using. Now since you've drilled a hole in it, so you just kind of wrap it around like that, nice and tightly, just like that. And then you'd get your duct tape and just go around the edge and putting it on and building it up, but you don't want to make duct tape go over that little hole there, because then you won't be able to fit your line through.
So I have a piece of duct tape. I'm just going to lay the skirt like that, and then just lift it up like that, and then just go like that the whole way around. Just like that.
So I've duct taped it all up, and then I accidentally went over that hole. So I've just got on my hook and jabbed it in there, moved it around a bit, and made it a bit of a hole there. So once you've done that, this is the tricky part. You have to stick your nylon through that hole there. I've got about that much line. Much there. I've got that all on the camera. So, through the hole. And the other side, just like that. And then you want to do a dropper, well, I don't know what knot it's called, but you want to do one of these knots. So you just get your line like that, wrap it around there. Hold on. You get your line, make it as big as you feel you want it,
wrap it around there like that and put it through this hole, and then just pull that tight like that. Just like that. Now,
so that was your swivel one that you just made here to clip onto your swivel. And now, this is going to be the one that you put your hook on, so you need to make it quite big.
That's probably the size that you're going to need. Then you're just going to clip that tail there. But you want to leave a little bit of tail, so just in case gets pulled too hard and it slips a bit. So now, it should just sit on your lure like that, and then stay there so it won't pull through, so the hook's gonna be in the right place. And that really matters for the hook in the right place, because if it's not in the right place, you can miss a big fish. Yeah. Yep. So you're going to need to squeeze the line there, and I'm just using this hook here. I reckon I'm just going to put it on, and then you're just going to do what you normally do and slide that over the hook. It's just like a normal trace there. And once you've done the hook on, you've done. That's your homemade lure. I've made a few of these in the past. This one doesn't have a hook on it. Of course, this one that I've just made here is much bigger. So that is a tutorial on how to make a trolling lure, or whatever. You could use it for trolling lures. You could catch maybe skipjack or albacore tuna on these. Yeah, maybe kawai. Okay, so that's it for today.